who journeyed in search of the Golden Fleece, is a mythical narrative that portrays the heroic qualities of persistent endeavor and courageous person. In Australia, untiring efforts and continued experiments in sheep breeding of men like John MacArthur have played an important part in firmly establishing Australia's greatest pastoral industry. The sheep breeder, constantly striving to improve his flocks, often pays fabulous sums for stud rams. During their period of useful life, these monarchs of the flock are treated with luxurious attention. Systematic cross-breeding produced the Australian Merino, a very hardy sheep, carrying an exceptionally heavy fleece of wool of superb quality. More than one quarter of the total wool of the world is produced in Australia under natural conditions. Flocks roam the land all the year round, feeding on natural pasture. At mustering time, all hands and the cook are busy. The flock master's daughter adds to the picturesqueness of the scene as she operates the drafting gate, separating the ewes from the lambs. Healthy sheep produce the finest wool. Therefore, precautionary measures are taken to ensure immunity from natural ills. The sheep are dipped for external cleansing. This helps to stimulate a healthy condition and improves the fleece preparatory to shearing. After the dip has drained off, the sheep receive a little internal treatment. Their medicinal tonic is administered by a spray gun, a gentle yet effective method. What would my mother have given for one of these? As shearing time approaches, sheep are mustered in the wide pastoral lands throughout the country. From the open plains, the wooded hills, the sheltered valleys, from north, south, east and west, flocks totaling over 113 million converge towards the shearing sheds to yield the Golden Fleece. Unhurried, but steadily alert, with confidence born of experience, the keen-eyed carrier accurately counts the sheep as they pass through the gate. Some of the sheep seem a little reluctant to go indoors. Perhaps some instinct warns them that they are to be fleeced of their woolly coats. Inside the shearing shed, the scene is one of industrious activity. To the accompaniment of the whir of machines and the chatter of combs and cutters, sheep after sheep is denuded of its fleece. The shearers work systematically, clippers with remarkable deftness and removing the whole fleece without injuring it. They certainly live up to the barber's slogan, "You're next, no waiting." Although it has been recorded that as many as 330 sheep have been shorn by one shearer in a working day of 8.5 hours, the average tally is from 120 to 150 sheep per man. Deprived of his fleecy covering, the transformed and bewildered sheep is put with his denuded fellows and is subjected to further humiliation by being branded. sheep remain in the home paddocks for a week or two after the shearing. In due time, beneficent nature will provide them with new fleeces as they roam the wide pastures. The shorn fleeces are taken to the rolling tables where they are thrown or spread out, the neck always in the one direction. The removal of inferior parts is known as skirting. The fleeces are then rolled and sorted. The wool classer must be capable of recognizing the value of inbred qualities. His judgment is the result of lengthy experience, and he is able to determine accurately the commercial value of the wool. The standard of wool qualities is fixed according to the diameter of the fiber, combined with the handle and spinning value of the wool. The term counts represents the spinning quality. The wool is pressed into bales of about 300 pounds gross weight, and these are stenciled with a brand indicating the source of the clip and the grade of the wool. With thoughtful calm, this grimly efficient-looking gentleman checks the weight of the bales and records the tally. Modern motor lorries are rapidly replacing the picturesque bullock teams for transporting the wool to market. Often scores of miles are traversed over country roads before the railway is reached. Over branch lines and arterial railroads throughout the country, the wool-laden trucks are hauled towards the city. The scene changes from the quiet pastoral areas of the country to the busy hustle of the metropolis. The trains with their valuable freight arrive at the wool stores where the trucks are unloaded. Waybills and consignment notes are checked. The bales are taken into the wool store where they are weighed and a record made of the breed and grade of the contents. In the display room, bales are opened so that the contents may be examined by the prospective buyers. The breeders responsible for this splendid collection of fleeces may feel justifiably proud of the keenness and mental alertness which resulted in this sort of wool gathering. Australia remains unchallenged as the finest wool-producing country in the world, both for quality and quantity. The auctioneer appraises the various lots offering, as do the buyers, representative of all nations. They know what they're to bid for, and how they bid. Just see them, and hear them.
Oh, that's 4, 10, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8,